Welcome back to another random video Thursday. Today in this video, I'm doing a quick review for this Yarna capacitive water descaler that I've been testing for the past 3 months. In a few of my past videos, if you followed along, you see that I've talked about my water filtration system here. And today in this video, I'm gonna talk about the Yarna descaler that I've actually installed right down there on my main pipe. How I have it installed is just plugged into a power cord up there. It runs down here to the pipe and then down to the main unit. Now, if you're concerned about having something on 24/7, 365, this only uses 3 watts of power. So it's basically like running a nightlight. It's just pennies a year. Now, with this being a capacitive type descaler versus the magnetic or induction types, that basically just means that the water is going to travel further down the pipe and stay treated as it goes further away. So this apparently goes up to around 2 miles versus a magnetic or induction type that only goes maybe 50 feet or so before the minerals start to reform. As far as installing it goes, it should look kind of like this. It doesn't really matter which direction you actually wrap the banding in, so long as it's close together without really overlapping too much. I guess the main question is, does this thing actually work? And to answer that, we're going to take a look at a couple things here. Now, my water is not that hard at only 140 parts per million of total dissolved solids. You can see here right in the back of my sink, this has been cleaned several times over the past couple months, and there's still plenty of hard water deposits here. You can see all this, white powdery looking stuff. And I haven't really noticed much reduction in that, maybe just slightly, but it's barely noticeable. And as far as wiping it off goes, it might be slightly easier to wipe it off without having to use anything like a CLR. One of the things I actually tried before installing the unit was cleaning the toilet really good. And right where the water line is, there'll be a hard water deposit ring, which is where the minerals will collect. And a lot of times the mold will grow into those minerals, and it'll be harder to clean that ring where the water line is. So what I actually did was cleaned it really good, and I actually had to use CLR to clean that off because it wasn't scrubbing off. And I purposely left it that way. I don't normally leave it that long. But anyways, I just cleaned it, and after 3 months of not cleaning it, this whole thing here cleaned right off without having to use any kind of harsh cleaner, just using the scrub brush and a regular toilet bowl cleaner that's not acidic, and it came right off no problem. In the shower here, I haven't really noticed much difference either. There's still mineral deposits forming right here on the edge of the shower head. So far, looking at those minor subjective benefits, I don't really think anyone would be sold on this unit, myself included. That is until I did the maintenance on my hot water tank, which I do once every 3 years by replacing the anode rod. So we're gonna take a look at that. So every 3 years with my hot water tank, I flush the tank and replace the anode rod. And this is what the anode rod looks like after it's been used up for 3 years. This is where electrolysis happens instead of the inside shell of your tank. This is why it's important to replace these so it makes your tank last longer. However, after I flushed my tank, I also took out all of this at the bottom of the tank after the first 3 years. This is all mineral sediment. This was actually expanded about 3 times this volume when it was wet, and this is what it looks like after it's been dried out. This time, after using the water descaler for 3 months, right before we replaced an anode rod, there was nothing on the bottom of the tank, and I'll show you with the picture here. So with an electronic water descaler, the warmer the water is, the longer the effects actually last in stopping the minerals from reforming in solution. So it seems to have the most benefit inside of a hot water tank in stopping buildup. So to answer the question, is this thing actually worth it? Well, that's really going to be up to you. For me, if it reduces the maintenance on my hot water tank, it seems to be very worth it if it only costs me pennies a year. So that's it for this video. If you're interested in this water descaler at all, it will be in the video description below. They will be affiliate links. I do get a small commission if you use those links, but it doesn't increase the price at all. So that's it. Thanks for watching.